Mr. Vice Chairman, sir, I am very thankful to you and the honorable members who have participated in the discussion. I have heard with great attention the various speeches made by the honorable members in the foregoing debate on this bill. Before reacting to the individual points made by the honorable members, I would like to say that the present amendment bill cannot be deemed to be a recodification of the entire Companies Act. This bill incorporates provisions of an urgent nature which have to be brought not only for the effective regulation of the corporate sector but also for its smooth functioning. The corporate sector encompasses various sections of the people and not only companies and their management. We have to protect the interest of the shareholders, the depositors, employees, public interest, while also looking at the interest of the companies and their management. If we go carefully through the various provisions embodied in the bill, you will find that the different provisions have taken care of the interests of different sections of the people, while on the one hand, there is a form being provided to depositors whose deposits are not returned by companies on time. On the other, the interest of those who apply for shares in a company are also being protected by the provisions relating to the refund of the application money when shares are not allotted. It has been made mandatory that the company will deliver share certificates and debentures certificates within a prescribed period of time. Similarly, when share transfers are refused and there is a dispute, provision is being made that pending settlement of the dispute, the transfer does not lose his rights over the dividends, rights share, bonus shares, etc. All these provisions are aimed at protecting the small investors and shareholders. My friend mentioned about non-furnishing of annual reports to the shareholders. It is not that we are not concerned that information needs to be furnished to the shareholders. However, it is felt that an average shareholder may not really require all the information that is published in the annual reports. My friend himself stated that the list of the employees drawing over a certain amount of salary can be done away with. It would be evident that he shares the view that all the information may not be essential for an एवरेज शेयर होल्डर स्टॉक।